Hello guys, I am Parinita and welcome back to my channel to polish your CSE concepts with me. So let's get started. Our today's video is one of the most important topics of theory of computation, that is DFA and NFA. You all must be aware of the terms at least. What is DFA? DFA stands for deterministic finite automata and NFA stands for non-deterministic finite automata. Now first of all, what is this NFA and DFA? In my previous videos of TOC, if you have visited, we have already discussed about different types of grammar in TOC, right? We have discussed type 0, type 1, type 2, type 3 grammar in detail. I think made two videos, one with the overview of what the grammars are, and in the second video we have discussed about different examples that if any language is given, how you can determine that language or that particular string or grammar belongs to which grammar, belongs to which type of grammar. We have seen those things in detail, right? So if you have not visited that, I would recommend you to go and visit that first. I will provide the link in the description so that you will get a clear idea on what different types of grammar are. Because what this NFA and DFA is, okay, let me give you an overview that we are having different types of grammar, right? Basically four types of grammar: type 0, type 1, type 2, type 3. Now, with respect to these four types of grammar, we are having four different type of languages, right? Based on the grammar, we are having four different languages, and we are having four different types of machines that accepts those type of languages. I hope you are getting, right? They are mapped, like we are having grammars. Those grammars are having some specific type of languages, and we are having some specific type of machines for these respective languages. So type 0, I will quickly tell you, so because this is a very important point, these basic points you must be remembering, right? See, type 0, I'm quickly saying, if you wish you can note it down somewhere, because this is a very important point. They can come in exams also. These are frequently asked small questions. First of all, we are having type 0. Type 0 is what? It is recursively enumerable language, and they are accepted by the machine which is known as Turing machine. Fine. Okay, let me write here. First, recursively enumerable languages, they are accepted by Turing machine. Fine. Then we are having context sensitive languages. They are accepted by the machine that is known as linear bounded automata. Then we are having context free languages that are accepted by pushed down automata. Then we are having regular languages, and they are accepted by finite automata. So these are the four different languages with respect to four different grammars, and they are managed by four different machines. So as I told, we have already discussed about the languages and the grammars in detail, that I will provide you the link in the description section. Now from this video onwards, we are going to see these languages one by one, these machines one by one. Fine. Okay, so first of all, the first language or the most restricted language, that is type 3 language, that is regular language. For regular language, the machine we are having is finite automata. Now there are, so in today's video we are going to learn about finite automata in detail. Now if I talk about finite automata, as the name itself indicates, finite. So the main point that you should be remembering about finite automata is, whenever the language length is specific or limited or finite, because as the name itself indicates, finite, right? So whenever the length is finite, means you are having finite length of string, like only AB 01 010, or it may be long, but it should be finite. If the length of the string is finite, then that is the first condition. Then and only then there is a possibility that it belongs to regular language. Fine. Okay. Now if we talk about finite automata, there are mainly two flavors of finite automata, that is DFA and NFA, deterministic and non-deterministic finite automata. Now what is the main difference between them? We will see with the help of example. I have taken one common example, and for that common example we will be drawing NFA as well as DFA, right? Okay, see the these small points, that every DFA is an NFA. Means if any NFA is given, we can say that it is DFA. So every DFA, sorry, if any DFA is given, that DFA can be counted as NFA. That is completely fine. Means if this is DFA, I can say that this is DFA and I can say that this is NFA also. So every DFA is an NFA, but not vice versa. Means for any NFA, I cannot say that it is DFA, right? Okay, there is an equivalent DFA for every NFA. What that means, that every NFA can be converted to an equivalent DFA. I hope you are understanding. If any DFA is given, we can say that yes, it is DFA and it is NFA also. But if any NFA is given, I cannot say that this is NFA as well as this is DFA. I cannot say that. But if any NFA is given and if I wish, I can convert it into an equivalent DFA. That is what this point says. Right. Apart from that, if I tell you some differences between NFA and DFA, because obviously we are going to see an example of NFA and DFA. So before seeing first the example, you must be knowing that what is the difference between NFA and DFA, right? That is very important to know. So there are certain points of differences between them. See, as you can see, the structure, both the structures are same. In both we will be having our states and the edges or the transitions. In both the cases we are having states as well as we are having the transitions. We will be having initial state, we will be having final state. Right, all those things are common in both. But what is the difference? See, the differences are, the first difference that I can tell you is, in NFA, the transition of null is allowed. The transition of null or lambda is allowed in this case. Right, in case of NFA, the transition of null or lambda is allowed. Means like this, this is the transition of 0, right? In this way, the transition for lambda is also allowed in case of NFA, whereas any transition of lambda is not allowed in case of DFA, right? This is the first point of difference. In the second point of difference, in NFA, we can have multiple choices, right? In NFA, we can have multiple choices, but we cannot have multiple choices in case of DFA. So what do we mean by multiple choices? For example, any state is there and with the help of one common input string, for example, A. With the help of A, I can go to this state also. With the help of A, I can go to this state also. Right, so we are having multiple options that with the help of same string, I can go to two different states. But this is not the case, or this is not the possibility in case of DFA, right? So this is one of the main differences. Then one more important difference is, there are three main differences. First is this, second is this, and the third difference, if I tell you. The third main difference is, in case of NFA, dead configuration is possible. Dead configuration is possible. Now, what do we mean by dead configuration? Dead configuration is possible means, see, for example, this state is there, A, right? From this state, here the string is 01, here the set of strings given is 01. So in this state A, we are having a transition for 0, but we are having no transition for 1, right? So we can say that for this state, we are having dead configuration for 1, because there is no configuration for 1. Right, you're understanding, with the help in from this state, we are having transition for one input symbol, but we are not having transition for another input symbol. That is completely fine in case of DFA. Whereas in case of, that is completely fine in case of NFA. Because in NFA, dead configuration is possible or is allowed. But in case of DFA, dead configuration is not allowed. That means what? From every state, we should be having transition for all the possible input strings. Fine. So these are the three main points of differences between these two. So whenever at the time of making DFA or at the time of making NFA, you should be remembering these three points very nicely, right? So here we will understand these two differences, the differences between these two with the help of one common example. Here the example or the question we are taking is, set all the strings over 01 that start with 0. We have to take all the possible strings over 0 and 1 that is starting with 0. That means all my numbers should start with 0, like 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, 0, anything like that, right? The only condition is it should start with 0. So if I am supposed to make NFA for it, it is very easy to make NFA. The thing is, I will be having one starting symbol. From starting symbol, what my only condition is in this question, my only condition is my string should start with a 0. So here, I will draw a transition from 0 in the very first state because I know that my first symbol must be 0. So here I have drawn one transition from 0, and once I reach 0, because see, apart from all these strings, only 0 is also allowed, right? Because 0 is also starting with 0, and we are not concerned that if anything is followed by 0 or not, right? So my only condition is it should start with 0. So I have made one transition for 0, and after 0, after it has reached this final state, from final state I can have any transitions for 0 or 1, right? Now after reaching 1, 0 is over, so I am reaching to final state. Now after reaching here, after 1, 0, I can have any number of 1s or 0s, I don't care. Right, so the only condition is the initial symbol should be 0, and after that anything should be there. So that's it. This is very simple NFA for the given statement, right? But now I don't need to check anything, because in NFA everything is allowed. Null transitions are allowed, multiple options are allowed, that configurations are allowed. So NFA is very simple to make, because we don't need to make any extra changes, make any extra checks. We don't need to check anything, right? So this is NFA and it is done. But when we are making DFA, we have to be extra careful. How? So see, let's say we want to make DFA for the same statement. So at the time of making DFA, again we are having one starting symbol. Again I know that it should be starting with 0. So again from 0 I am making one transition, and on 0, because 0 is also possible, only 0 is also possible. So as soon as I am getting one 0, I will get the final state. And after final state, whatever I am getting, 0 or 1, whatever I am getting, it will be in the final state only. That's it. Fine. So I have made up to this, right? I have made this much. And after making this much in DFA, I have to go and I have to check these things. Okay. So the first thing is for DFA we are taking. So for DFA, null transitions, see these, I have written these 3 points for NFA, right? So for DFA, it will be just opposite. So the very first point is for DFA, null is not allowed. So is there, up to this, is there any null transitions we have done? No. So we are completely fine with it. Then multiple choices for same input string is not allowed. In DFA, with the help of same input string, multiple choices are not allowed. So have we done anything like this here? From this state, from 0, only one possibility is there. And from this state, on 0 and 1, only one possibility is there. So again, we are okay with it. Then third point, in DFA, dead configuration is not allowed, right? In DFA. What do we mean by dead configuration? That dead configuration is not allowed means what? Means from every state, we should be having transitions for every input symbol. So if we check up to here, see, from the state B, yes, we had having transition for 0 as well as for 1, so it is completely fine. But when we are checking the state A, we are having transition for 0, but we are having no transition for 1. So our DFA is not yet completed. So what we need to do is, with the help of or from the state A, I have to draw a transition for my input symbol 1, because my two strings are there, 0 and 1. So for 0 I am already having transition. Now I have to make transition for 1 also. So what I will do, I will make a transition for 1, but should, see, this is my initial state, right? So from the initial state I am getting 1, is it allowed? No, because my statement says that my language should always start with 0. So in case in the very first step I am getting 1, means if it is starting with 1, it is not allowed. So what I can do, from the transition 1, I will go to a state that is a dead state or trap state. So here I am taking a state C from the transition of 1, I am taking it to a state C, and this state C, I am declaring it as a dead state or trap state. Means from this state, we are not going anywhere because this is not allowed, like that. But we have to show that in case of DFA. Why we have to show that? Because in DFA, that configuration is not allowed. So I have to show the transition and I have to show that it is going to a dead state or trap state if initially we are getting 1. And again, after getting 1, no matter what we are getting, we will always remain in the dead state only. So from 1, we are going to dead state, and from the dead state, either we are getting 0 or we are getting 1, we will remain in that state itself. Fine, so this is the main difference between NFA and DFA. Making NFA is very simple because you don't need to make any extra checks, but making DFA is quite complicated. You have to check all these things, and in case any of these cases is violated in case of DFA, you have to change your DFA accordingly so that all the rules are maintained. Fine, and I have already told you 3 main differences between NFA and DFA. So that's all about NFA and DFA. They are togetherly known as finite state machine. Finite state machine for regular language. Fine. So as I told, we in this video, we have covered about our first machine for type 3 language, that is regular language. Right. Now in our next videos, we will talk about PDA. We will talk about pushdown automata, linear bounded automata, and Turing machine. One by one, we will discuss about all the things. I hope you have understood this video or this topic well. If you really liked the video, let me know in the comment section, and please share it with your friends also. Thank you so much.